friends, we're gathered here today to witness the marriage of this woman and this man, promising them our support by our presence here today. Mackenzie and Will have invited us to share in the celebration of one of life's most sacred relationships, wherein they promise to guard the welfare of each other more carefully than their own. They pledge their faith to one another as they enter into the joys and privileges of marriage. True marriage is built on love. It fulfills another's need, it adjusts continually, it gives instead of demands, and forgives willingly. So Will, I ask you these questions. Do you take Mackenzie to be your wife? Do you commit yourself to her? To give yourself to her in love and in work? Do you promise to cherish her above all others and to respect her individuality, encouraging her to grow and to become all that God intends?
I do.
You know, when Mackenzie was a little girl, her mother and I prayed every night for the right man for her to meet, to marry. And that man had to satisfy the four C's. The first C was he had to be a strong Christian, a man of faith. Secondly, he had to be a man of character, a man of integrity. Thirdly, he has to be a great companion, someone who you can have fun with. And when you look at Will and Mackenzie, when do they not have fun? I mean, come on. They love to cook and eat. They love to party.
Celebrate the marriage of Mackenzie and Will and the start of their new life together as husband and wife. I can still remember the day she was born and meeting her for the first time in the hospital. From that day on, I knew I had a responsibility to look out for her.
Me and my brother were super competitive growing up. I mean, if everyone knows Will, you know, he's really competitive. You know, we play video games, controllers would get broken. Obscenities would get cussed. Don't worry, Mom, they're mostly in our heads. You know, we were young. Honestly, all the jokes aside, I never thought that my brother would settle down. I looked up to him quite frequently as a younger brother, and it honestly didn't really click until I saw him see Mackenzie walk down the aisle, and he started crying. I never seen my brother cry before, so that was a very touching moment for me, honestly.
Too grown for games? Are we too grown to play around? Young enough to chase, but old enough to know better.
Are we too grown to change? Are we too grown to mess around? Oh, and I can't wait forever, baby. Both of us.
Finally, the fourth C, you gotta have chemistry with this guy. I think you figured that out. Will, you're the man. You're the man to answer our prayers.
Do you take Will to be your husband? Do you commit yourself to him? To be responsible in the marriage relationship, to give yourself to him in love and in work, to invite him fully into your being so that he may know who you truly are, you promised to cherish him above all others and to respect his individuality, encouraging him to grow and to become all that God intends.
I do.
I, William Frederick Seitz III, take you, Mackenzie Jean Webster, for my lawful wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
I, Mackenzie Jean Webster, take you, William Frederick Seitz III, for my lawful husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better and for worse, for richer and for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
Good job.
Friends, before God and in the presence of all of us gathered here today, Will and Mackenzie have made their solemn vows to each other. They have confirmed their promises by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Now, by the authority committed unto me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and in accordance with the laws of the great state of Wisconsin, I declare that Will and Mackenzie are now husband and wife. You make history.
I've never been like this. I've never been so scared to say hey, say your name every day. I'm afraid that you'll hear it and you might not care. I've never been in love, but this is close enough. Daydream like me, I think we be like
Mackenzie. A from above. Ooh, you don't know how much Mom and I love you. We are so proud of you. It is such an honor and privilege to be your father and to celebrate this wedding.
I've got a crush on you. I think too much. I do. Can't keep it on the hush. Try to play it cool, but I'm a fool, cause I still got a crush on you. I still got a crush on you. I still got a crush. I wanna take you home.
The last wedding that I was a part of, I may have got overserved, and one thing led to another, and I might have, you know, taken a lot of clothing off at that wedding while I was dancing. So they're like, hey, you can get overserved. We encourage you. We actually want you to do it. So without further ado, let's cue the music for me.
Thunder.
Are you not entertained? Is this not why you are here?
I've only known Will for a couple of years, but I want him to know how excited we are for him to be a part of our family.
Will, we love you, and Mackenzie. We love you to the moon and stars and back.
I wish you two all the love and happiness in the world. Let's all raise our glasses to the bride and groom and wish them a lifetime of love and joy.
To the new Mr. and Mrs. William Frederick Seitz III.
Lightning and the thunder, thunder, thunder. Feel the thunder.